cock back it up. Now, if you were, you know, as Kid Rock's career kind of, you know, grew and evolved since his self-titled debut, Rich Times for Breakfast, so November 20th, 2001, this record really, like, you know, Double O' Cause was the record that put Kid Rock on the map. This record, it was like a whole new, like, it just took life of its own. The album came out on November 20th, 2001. The album's known for featuring a developed picture with, of course, do it with Sheryl Crow. I was like, when I heard a picture, when I heard the song Picture from the record, and it was being as a duet, I'm thinking, wow, Kid Rock really kind of, you know, evolved in so many genres, not just being a rock blues, and, you know, he sometimes likes to dial it back a little bit in his music, but, you know, it just goes to show that Kid Rock can't just be a one-hit wonder, as they say. He's always evolving, you know, in his, you know, evolving his hip-hop roots, southern rock, heavy metal, country. He likes to, you know, mix it up from time to time, but this record was dedicated to his former assistant slash hype man, the late great Josie, who passed away in November of that previous year. 75 songs were written for the album. The third record as a song for the album, one of the records that did not make the album was If I Was President. Standard Blues, song that Kid Rock plays for being a concert, and song left out of that was the Josie Eulogy in Your Lifetime. Picture received a CMA nomination for 2003 for Vocal Event of the Year, will go on to be Rock's first gold single. Several songs were recorded during the album such a period on a self-titled record. You know, the record really saw a shift in his sound, featuring more ballads and less rap in the previous album, featuring more classic rock influence. You know, critics and journalists believed that music is a compass of hard rock, hip hop, heavy metal, and southern rock. Entertainment leader writer Robert Scrabcock is a concept about staying a boastful, defensive, confrontational, and thin skin, loud, rude, proud of it. You know, and Kid Rock is a composite of one of the puzzle stereotypes, sure, scared neighbor, strutting, ghetto pimp, and scared rebellion, redneck, heavy metal, burnout, truck grounds, and contains south of Wizard of Oz. Murray described Midnight Train to Memphis as a more country, millennial of a piece of power ballad. I mean, the record itself, like, I was just like, thank you. what, say how, say who, the what. Thousands of people, thousands, kick the computer.